everybody. Welcome back to episode number 7 of Quarantalks. So you have the usual gang here with Will, Espy, Julio, Carmen, and myself. So you already know how we start every episode with. Starts with the joke of the day. So I always feel like I pick on Carmen, so I'm going to pick on Carmen again. So okay. Go ahead, Carmen.
Okay, this one's funny. Okay. So, why couldn't the pony sing a lullaby? Because she was a little horse.
Yes, I knew it.
Bro, we did it last time.
You're already doing that to me.
Call it intuition.
Okay, well, I'm popcorning it over to Axel.
Me? Okay, I told the doctor I broke my arm in 2 places, so he told me not to go to those 2 places.
Bruh.
That was good.
Okay.
Go, Ethan.
All right, so I actually have 2. I'm going to let y'all pick either joke A or joke B.
B.
C.
A.
B.
Oh. Let's go with joke number B. Alright. Letter B. Okay, whatever. So, you know the computer manufacturers, right? Dell and HP?
Mm-hmm.
They had a kid together. What do they call the child?
A Dell.
No.
That would have been funny.
It wasn't. It was they called her Data. Like Data?
Yeah.
Data.
Nope. No.
Wasn't
funny.
Wanna try
A?
Try again.
Okay, yeah. Let me try A.
Cut that out, Julio. Cut that out.
Okay. Alright. What do you call a bear without teeth?
A gummy bear.
Yes, Carmen. There. There you go.
Damn.
Do you have a joke, C?
Yes, I do. Yes.
Oh my god.
Alright. Why was a cheetah always mad in the hand of poker?
Because he's a cheetah?
No. Because people called him a lion.
Nah.
Okay, next person. Next person. Julio, go.
Okay, I got you guys. Wait, don't ruin it if you know it. Why did the mushroom go to the party?
Oh, I know this. I want to.
That's my joke.
My God.
It was your joke.
It was your joke. And no one's saying it.
First podcast.
Because he was a fun guy.
Oh my god. I suggest you pick Axel so SB can have time to scramble. Alright, Axel, let her rip.
Axel already went.
I said Julio.
I said Axel.
Yeah, it was Carmen, then me, then you, then Julio, now to SB.
Oh, SB, your time's up. I tried buying some time.
Y'all are lucky I had a backup joke.
Bruh.
What's the best thing about Switzerland?
Oh, I've heard of this one.
I don't know.
I mean, say it again. Wait.
It's a thing about the flag.
So, what's the best thing about Switzerland?
Their cheese.
I mean, I don't know, but the flag is a big plus.
Nah.
Yeah, there you go.
I thought that was England.
No, England has like an X.
Switzerland? Yeah.
Oh,
England
wow.
Is like an X and a little line in the middle.
Oh, well, Switzerland is red with a white cross on it.
Yeah.
Alright, so for the quote of the day, we have a Mr. You know him well? Is gonna be Julio.
Okay, so today's quote of the day comes from Dr. Wayne W. Dyer, who once said, My goal is not to be better than anyone else, but to be better than I used to be.
Nice.
So I thought this quote was quite meaningful because my last quote dealt with dealing with a goal and how you shouldn't give up to reach, how you shouldn't give up to reach it no matter how long it takes. So it's like it adds icing to the cake.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I like it. Okay. Very nice.
Jinx yell me a soda. Well, very nice quote, Leo.
Thank you.
Our next segment is going to be weird conspiracy theories. Well, not weird, just conspiracy theories. So, I'll tell you what. I always feel like I pick on Carmen.
I hope this is going where I think it's going.
So I'm not going to pick on Carmen.
Woo!
I'm going to pick on Barman. Go ahead.
No. Okay. But I actually have a really cool one. Okay.
I want to hear this.
So I don't know if y'all know this one, but there's a conspiracy that Walt Disney's head is frozen.
No, I know.
I've heard of that one.
Have y'all heard that?
Yeah, I told me.
It's cool. Okay, so basically for those of y'all who don't know, Walt Disney passed away of lung cancer in 1966. I pulled up some sources. And, like, supposedly he was cremated, but it was, like, they kind of delayed telling people about his death. So it was, like, very private, like, his funeral and everything. And then there was a source. Let's see. It says right here. A man named Bob Nelson. He's a president of Cryonic Society of California. He told the LA Times that Walt Disney was interested in being frozen. So then that doesn't really say much, but then like after he died, there's a lot of people saying that he did get frozen after all. And then to top it off, because there's so many like searches and stuff, they made Frozen the movie. So that way when you look up Walt Disney Frozen, the movie comes out.
Mm.
Yes, and the theory is being like referenced in like Family Guy and iCarly. I don't know if you guys have seen that iCarly episode with Charles Dingle.
Yeah, I vaguely remember it.
No.
That episode is like they go to like a network studio and then
I remember it's like a special episode. Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, that's my conspiracy theory. Could be true.
Or maybe
true.
It was like
Nickelodeon. Huh?
It was like Nickelodeon and Disney beef.
Yeah. And they say that his body or like his head is under the Pirates of Caribbean ride at Disneyland.
Let's go check it out.
So yeah, that's mine. Yeah, I'll pass it on to Ethan.
I'm always getting picked on here.
No, you're not.
All right. So, my conspiracy theory is about Stonehenge. Aliens built it. Think about it. Okay, watch.
Where are your sources?
Believe it?
Listen, it's in Wiltshire, England, right? So, this is like way, way, way back. I'm talking like BC, like before that, you know, it's way back. I don't know the exact dates because I wasn't born then or thought of, but basically think about it. Those are like mega stones, and the way that they're placed and formed, human technology was not that advanced to move, much less arrange those stones in such a perfectly arranged order. Like, think about it. How do you get two huge stones to stand upright? Like, how much force do you think that takes, logically speaking?
You're right. And
then, to top it off, we're going to place an even bigger stone on top of it. Like, think about it. Who put the stone up there?
I did.
Okay, now it was the stone. Okay, it's like, it's arranged in a perfect circle almost. So, think about it. If you do it from above, it's actually pretty easy. And if you have something that can, like, harness, like, the rocks, I guess you can say. or hook him up, aliens would be able to do that. Like with their their magnet rays or whatever, like the things you see in movies or whatever. That's my conspiracy theory. I'm not saying I believe it. I'm just saying we need to take some deeper look into it.
That's good.
All right, I'm going to pick, let's see, Wheel. I feel like you got something juicy. Let it rip.
Yes, sir. I hope nobody has this one, but the landing on the moon was fake. Well, at least the picture was.
Explain your reason.
Well, the picture is people. I got this from New York Magazine, just saying, the source. And the picture says that the shadows of the astronaut should be facing in front of them, but they're behind them, even though the sun itself was behind them. So why is the shadow behind them also? That makes no sense. Mm-hmm. Think about it. And in the photo, you could also see that there is no stars in our space, even though there's supposed to be billions and millions of stars, you know? Mm-hmm. Fishy, huh? Nah, but, you know, the flag also, it should not be moving. And in the picture, it looks like it was, like, waving, you know, like, creased or whatever. Even though there is no air in our space. So, yeah. It's a lot about, you know, think about it.
Interesting.
And I don't know why, but New York Magazine also said that maybe the moon itself is not just hollow, but probably an alien satellite.
Oh.
Alien satellite.
Yeah. I don't know. New York Magazine's on some next level stuff.
But you know what I mean? Some very hot takes.
Yeah. I don't know. That's all they have to say. So, yeah. I believe it. No fake. There's no way.
On another side, we were talking about the moon, right? So, did y'all hear that the Pentagon released the proof that the UFO exists?
Oh, yeah. I did see that.
Like, a month ago, but nobody paid attention to it. I was very surprised about that. But that's not my conspiracy.
I never heard about that.
Yeah, I saw the videos. They're like old videos.
Mm-hmm. But it's like, why release them now? Out of nowhere.
Because of the virus.
Yeah, it's a whole, it's a global pandemic.
To distract you.
Yeah. It's called the art of sleight of hand.
So my conspiracy theory is a little bit less known. It's more of, it's more down to earth. Involves the royal family. So we all know Harry and Meghan, right? We know how Harry like left the British royal family and whatever.
Yeah.
But why? Why? So I'm thinking here, it's a long con. All right. So say they have more than one child, right? One of them suddenly goes into politics. Suddenly decides he wants to be the president. Now, by default, even if Harry has left the line of like the successors to the throne, that kid could potentially be in line to be the ruler of England, right? And now if he runs for president and he at the same time wants to like take his throne, it could potentially unite both America and Britain again. So I'm just thinking it's a British long con to regain American territory, just to gain it back. Crazy, but because it would be like something that's just on the long run, on the off chance. But what is, you know?
Yeah, he still has a chance.
Because it's like he left out of nowhere. Sure, say he wanted to leave royalty, but who does that? Who wants that? You know? And why? Why then? Why, as soon as he has a child, does he think, oh, you know what? I'm gonna leave everything I have now and go live in America.
Hmm.
You know? It's just weird. The timing's weird. Everything's just a little bit weird. So I think they're just trying to make America Great Britain again.
Interesting.
That's my conspiracy theory. And I mean, that would be a strong point. But yeah, so now on to the last theory with Julio.
Okay, so I don't really believe in these conspiracy theories because I got my tinfoil hat on. But I'll tell you this. Conspiracy theories are conspiracy theories on itself, because I actually think that it's just so the government could distract you, such as, like, SP had mentioned how the Pentagon randomly, like, released those UFO video sightings, and, like, no one really cared, which I thought was interesting, because maybe they were just trying to, like, stray people away from Corona or something, but you never know. Or simply it's just so, like, people can start drama, because, like, some of these conspiracy theories are so dumb, and, like, they got, like, this whole, for example, the flat earth people. No, I'm kidding. But, like, you get, like, these groups out here and stuff to agree with them, and I don't know, it's just, like, a tactic in my eyes. So I just leave it like that.
Man, you're right. I mean, we've become so complacent to just what we know.
or maybe it's just that I haven't, like, heard a conspiracy theory that has actually, like, interested me. But we'll see.
Well, those are our little conspiracy theories that we thought were pretty interesting. So that's weird. So our next and final segment will be our thoughts on Laredo slowly opening up. Well, really, we can go Laredo / Texas because, you know, the governor type, whatever. But I'm going to let SB give her thoughts. I feel like she's a very opinionated person.
That is true.
I mean, not to offend anybody or anything, but come on. Really? I get it. We don't want to be at home. It gets boring. But safety over everything. I'm a worrying person. So I just wish we could, you know, stick it out a bit. But I mean, we do have everything still going on, like the whole thing 6 feet apart. Most dining places don't let people dine in. It's just takeout still. And everything. So I can't really complain because, you know.
Yeah.
I can't do anything about it. But yeah. We should stay close. That's my final thought on that. Who's next? Julio, let's get it.
Alright, so I'm a little bit, like, in the middle with this dilemma. So, like, I know I have, like, on Facebook, like, these COVID updates. And I always see that, like, Webb County always has, like, the cases are always going up. So, like, I still feel like this virus is just getting worse. So, I would disagree on, like, opening up anything yet because it's still too early. But then again, like, I am, like, dying in my house here. And I miss the gym. So, like, I feel like I'm risking it for the biscuit. But I don't know, like, you know, I'm in between. Like, I think it's a bad idea. But at the same time, like, with the right precautions, it's not that bad. So, I'm kind of, like, in a pickle. And I'm only saying that because I'm thinking of, like, going to the gym. but for the people that, like, do agree, like, I would just say to, like, make sure to take care of yourself. And if, like, you are worried about this, just, like, stay inside for now. Because I do, like, if people say that, like, it's too early, I could get that, you know. But if they say, like, something opposite, I can agree to that as well. Because, like, we have been quarantined for, what, like, is it more than a month already?
It's like 2 months.
Two months?
That's a while.
We've been in quarantine for a while. So, like, it wouldn't hurt if we opened up a couple of, like, well, not even a couple. Like, Texas is going all out right now, right, with phase two. Mm-hmm. But, like, I don't know. I'm just, And well, what's the word, like in the middle? I'm not sure what another. Indifferent. Yeah, that sounds about right. Like I agree, like on both sides.
I get that.
But yeah, that's kind of like where I'm at right now. I just don't know what to do. I'll pass it on to Axel.
Like Julio said, like if you're worried about the, you know, COVID-19, like I don't think it should really bother you. You're gonna stay inside regardless, because it's just in our blood, it's human nature to be scared of stuff like this. And I get the people that want to go outside, but they also should not be complaining when they do get positive. Like if the cases keep going higher and higher, like there's always those people that start complaining, like, why'd y'all open it? And it was like them complaining also that they should open. So it's like people like that. Yeah. Gonna, I don't know. Because the cases are, they're always going to go higher and higher. It's nothing we could do about it, to be honest. I mean, if we open up, it's just going to speed up the process, to be honest. But it's nothing we could do. In the long run, it's going to be the same result. The cases keep going higher. I don't know. I'm mixed. I have mixed feelings about this.
Yeah, there you go. Mixed feelings. Oh, so dumb.
Nah, but like, if you're worried, like we said, just stay inside. Nothing will happen if you stay inside, unless you have a family member that goes outside, then, you know, GG's. But
good game.
Where's it gone? Ethan and Carmen, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, I'll go with E, Carmen.
Okay.
Very smooth.
Well, yeah, like y'all were saying, I'm kind of in the middle about it too, but only because, like, I mean, thinking about it from, like, a realistic point of view, like, our economy was, like, you know, getting kind of bad because there wasn't any sales and stuff happening. But I think that, like, if we had all just stayed inside, this quarantine wouldn't have lasted for so long, you know? And then we could have, like, you know, it's like a small sacrifice for a small amount of time for us to go back to the way things were. Because, like, I don't know, a lot of people took it really lightly. And then, like, it's, like, also now, like, especially that everything's opening up, everyone's leaving and stuff. And it's like, well, like Axel said, like, it's just going to get worse. So, like, we just needed to set, like, actual, I don't know, like, a good amount of time to actually quarantine instead of, like, letting people go out and stuff, you know? I don't know. I feel like this quarantine wouldn't have lasted as long, and we would have gotten things back to normal, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'm kind of in the middle about it, too. Because I can see both perspectives, like, about the economy and stuff, like, opening stuff back up. But I can also see that, like, how opening it up is going to just create more cases. So, I mean.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'll pass it over to Ethan.
Okay. So, I'm going to read y'all what the First Amendment says. Just the first sentence, right? The First Amendment guarantees freedoms concerning religion, expression, assembly, and the right to petition. So, I mean, if you want to take it at an ethical standpoint, you can't stop somebody from going out. Because technically, you know, our rights is like literally like the first like amendment in the Bill of Rights.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I feel like, one, there is nowhere near the amount of testing necessary. You look at other countries like Japan or some Northwestern European countries, like they're doing a rapid amount of testing and they're getting back to somewhat sense of normalcy or pre-coronavirus society. So I can see that. But as far as the economy, yes, it's hurting. Like if you have stocks, like, you know, I know in person because I have stocks too, so I felt it. But it's only gonna bounce back more. Like, you're gonna have like a great return on investment. So if you really like know like your finances, now is like a great time to start buying up the stocks. So that way, like, once the economy does bounce back, which it, I promise you it will, you can make money off those stocks. Yes, like, I miss my old sense of life. Not having a curfew, being able to sit down and eat my Whataburger in the restaurant instead of, like, in the car, like, looking around for people to see if they're watching me. going out at least, like, on a weekend with my friends, stuff like that. Yes, I do miss it, but it's like it's bigger than me. Me personally speaking, I realize that it's bigger than me. So I just take those precautions. Like whenever I go run outside and I see a group of people coming, I go around them like within 6 feet. Like these are things that I just like before the coronavirus, I probably just jogged right by them. But now that we're in this, it's like, okay, let me just give them their space and do my thing. So you can still have a somewhat sense of normalcy if that's what you want, but it's not going to be completely normal. You want to get a haircut, learn how to cut hair. That's something I'm probably going to start looking how to do just because me, I miss the feeling of having a fresh cut, but do I want all the barbershops to open up? No, I don't think it's a good idea because I don't know who has what or where you've been or who you've been in contact with. Simply speaking.
Mm-hmm.
Do I miss the gym? Of course I miss the gym. I look skinnier. I went from a lifter to a runner. That's how bad I need the gym. But yeah. I can see why they say we had to start opening some things up. Just because it's been too long in some people's eyes, but then again, not everybody's the same. And really, when you think about it, let's just say, right, for, like, the cases do start dropping down, and life goes back to normal in Texas, right? People are going to look at the governor as like, oh, he's a genius. Why didn't, like, the other states follow this, right? But then again, it's like, okay, one, Texas is not like other states. It's larger geographically than a state like New York, and it's more population dense, like per square mile compared to New York. So it's just very different. So I just think we have to like wait and see what happens. It's rather early to form an opinion from my perspective.
Yeah, I see that.
That's pretty smart.
Thank you. Do y'all think this is going to go on till next year?
I hope not.
Ooh. Oh, I hope not. But I think like halfway to next year, yeah. If cases just keep piling up.
Is it going to get worse when it gets colder?
Yeah.
Because it's getting worse and there hasn't been a cure.
No. But did y'all see that? Wait, no, I don't know. That Trump was saying that he was going to see if they can get a vaccine before we go back to school.
Not gonna happen. I really doubt that.
I mean, it's because really, like, you can't get a vaccine for like a virus because when you think about it,
processes.
Like the flu is always here. Like the flu is like, is always gonna come. But you have the flu shot, but it changes every year. Then I saw somewhere, I think in a British newspaper. I want to say it was the Guardian. I could be wrong. It said that the flu or the coronavirus just may become like one of those seasonal flus, like the average flu, just something that we adjust to. You get me?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
It's not common. Yeah, it like the common cold, but it's definitely not common. But yeah.
I see that.
But I don't know. I'm thinking. I want to say, within a definite 3 years' time, we should be going back to our regular lives, 3 years' time. So it's 2020. By 2023, that's when I'm like...
The end of the world.
Stop.
Oh, my God.
Please.
Stop it, Julio.
Oh, you know what? Now I just thought of, like, I don't know if it's considered a conspiracy, but, like, supposedly, like, you know how the world was going to end on 2012? They're like, what if it was supposed to be, like, 2021 or something? Because, like, they mixed the numbers.
Like,
nah.
Were you trying to mind dyslexic?
Maybe. I forgot where I read that from. But like, if next year the world ends, you heard it from me.
If it does, and I'll come looking for you. How about that?
Just put it in the chat like you were right.
$5, people.
Okay. You gotta give me all your money before we die.
Well, this brings episode number 7 of Quarantalks to an end. So we'll see you all next week for our final episode. And hope you guys stay safe out there and have a good week.
Take care.
Damn. Hashtag
Hasta luego.